Welcome to Joanna's library. Enjoy the story.
Mr. Man, Adventure in Space. 奇先生妙小姐冒险故事。火星的秘密任务。Written by Roger Hargreaves. 参考马爱农翻译。
Mr. Ron had just got a job as a tour guide at Space Center.
错误先生刚找到一份工作，在航天中心当导游。
He was very proud of his new job, so he invited all his friends to the Space Center to show them around.
他为这份工作感到非常骄傲，于是把朋友们都请到航天中心，带他们到处参观。
Mr. Ron showed his friends the first spacecraft that had landed on the moon.
错误先生向朋友们展示了第一艘登陆月球的宇宙飞船。
This is the first kettle to land on the moon, explained Mr. Ron.
错误先生解释说，这是第一个登上月球的烧水壶。
That is not a kettle, said Little Miss Wise.
聪慧小姐说，这才不是个水壶呢。
He showed them round the huge hall where Saturn V rocket was kept.
错误先生又带他们参观存放土星五号运载火箭的大厅。
And he showed them how to put on a space suit.
还向他们示范怎么穿航天服。
I don't think that's quite right, said Little Miss Wise.
聪慧小姐说，我觉得你这种穿法不对。
And then, Mr. Ron took them outside where there were two rockets standing side by side.
紧接着，错误先生又带大家到大厅外面。那里并排竖立着两艘火箭。
We can have a look inside Rocket 2, said Mr. Ron.
我们可以进二号火箭看看，错误先生说。
And they all traveled up in a lift to the hatch at the top of the rocket.
大家都乘电梯登上了那艘火箭顶部的座舱。
Rocket 1 is going to be launched on a mission to Mars today, explained Mr. Ron, pointing to the other rocket.
一号火箭即将被发射到火星上执行任务。错误先生指着另一艘火箭解释道。
They climbed through the hatch and were all standing admiring the space capsule when suddenly,There was a rumble.
大家登上了火箭，他们正站着欣赏太空舱，突然传来了一阵隆隆声。
A rumble that built into a roar.
隆隆声又变成了轰鸣声。
那轰鸣声震得火箭剧烈颤抖摇晃。The noise was extraordinary.
那响声震耳欲聋。
It was like 1,000 elephants all trumpeting and stumbling at the same time.
响的就像一千头大象同时在咆哮、跺脚。
Rocket 2 had lifted off.
二号火箭升空了。
They were on the wrong rocket.
错误先生，他们上错了火箭。
They were going into space.
他们正飞向太空。
Mr. Ron looked at all his friends, and all his friends stared at Mr. Ron.
错误先生和他的朋友们，你看看我，我看看你，面面相觑。
Oops, he said sheepishly.
哎呀，错误先生不好意思地说。
The rocket sailed into the sky.Leaving a great trail of smoke.
火箭飞入天空，尾部拖着一大股浓烟。
Mr. Ron and his friends stood in a huddle, wondering what was going to happen next. And then a hatch door opened.
错误先生和朋友挤成一团，不知道接下来会发生什么。突然有一扇舱门打开了。
It was an astronaut.
一位宇航员出现在他们面前。
An astronaut who looked just as surprised as the rest of them.
那位宇航员看上去和他们一样惊讶。
Who are you? He exclaimed.
他惊叫道，你们是谁？
We got on the wrong rocket.Explained Little Miss Wise. Who are you?
聪慧小姐解释说，我们上错了火箭。你又是谁呢？
I'm Captain Strongarm, and we are on a mission to Mars.
我是斯特朗阿姆舰长，我们要去火星执行一项任务。
Mars, gulped Mr. Worry. Could you just take me home first?
火星，担心先生倒吸了一口凉气。你能先把我送回去吗？
I'm sorry, we can't return until we have completed our mission, said Captain Strongarm.
斯朗阿姆舰长说，对不起，我们只有完成了任务才能回去。
Oops, said a little voice in the corner for the second time that day.
哎呀，角落里传出了一个小小的声音。这是那天第二次传出这个声音了。
Can you show us where we are going? Asked Little Miss Wise.
聪慧小姐问，谁能告诉我们火箭正往哪里飞吗？
Sure, this is our solar system, and there are 8 planets.
当然可以了。这是我们所处的太阳系，这里一共有八大行星。
This is Earth and this is Mars, the captain said, pointing to a large screen.
这是地球，这是火星。斯特朗阿姆舰长指着一个大屏幕说
This is the sun. We don't want to get too close to that, because the sun is so hot.We would sizzle like a sausage.
这是太阳，我们可不能靠太阳太近，这是因为它太烫了，我们会像香肠一样被烤得滋滋冒油的。
Sausages, murmured Mr. Greedy. Yummy.
贪吃先生嘟囔着说，香肠，好吃好吃。
There were lots of strange things in space.
太空里有许多奇奇怪怪的事情。
For one, there was no gravity, and they all found themselves floating about carbon.
比如，太空里没有引力，他们发现他们都悬浮在太空舱里。
Mr. Topsy-Turvy did not know whether he was the right way up.All the wrong side down.
颠倒先生不需要椅子就能坐着，他不知道自己是正的还是倒的。
But then, Mr. Topsy-Turvy is very used to that feeling.
不过，颠倒先生很习惯这种感觉。
They found a black hole, and Captain Strongarm explained to them thatThere was nothing in a black hole.
他们发现了一个黑洞。斯特朗阿姆舰长对他们解释说，黑洞里什么也没有。
Even so, Mr. Nosey, being the nosy fellow he was, had to go outside and have a look.
尽管如此，什么事情都想探听清楚的管闲事先生，还是要出去看个究竟。
On the way to Mars, they had to carry out some repairs, which meant leaving the rocket to go out for a spacewalk.
去往火星途中必须执行一些修理任务，
这就意味着他们要离开火箭去太空行走。Mr. Lazy discovered that this was just the kind of walk that he liked.
懒惰先生发现这种行走方式正是他喜欢的。
Not so much walking, but more floating on his back.
不太像走路，更像是仰面漂浮在太空中。
Finally, after months flying through space, they arrived on Mars.
他们在太空里飞行了几个星期，终于到达了火星。
To everyone's surprise, they were not the first ones there.
大家吃惊地发现，他们并不是第一批到达这里的人。
Is that a Martian? Asked Mr. Worry nervously.When they saw a tent,
当他们看见一顶帐篷时，担心先生提心吊胆地问：“
那是火星人吗？” Nobody had an answer, not even little Miss Wise.
没有人能回答，就连聪慧小姐也不能。
But it wasn't a Martian; it was Mr. Impossible.
然而。那不是什么火星人，而是不可能先生。
On a camping trip.
他正在露营呢。
I always come here for the summer, said Mr. Impossible. I like to get away from it all.
不可能先生说，我夏天总到这里来度假，我喜欢远离喧嚣。
That's impossible, said Captain Strongarm, shaking his head.In disbelief.
太不可思议了，斯特朗阿姆舰长说着，难以置信地摇了摇头。
They unloaded the moon buggy, although little Miss Wise did point out that it ought to be called the Mars buggy.
大家把月球车搬了出来，尽管聪慧小姐特别指出应该叫它火星车。
They had landed on a vast, flat plain of red dust.
他们降落在一片辽阔的红土平原上。
There was nothing to see for miles around.
方圆数英里之内什么都看不到。
Except for one rock.
只有一块岩石。
One rock that Mr. Clumsy managed to drive into.
尽管就只有一块岩石，笨手笨脚先生还是开车撞了上去。
Suddenly, an alarm sounded.
突然警报响起。
What's that? Shrieked Mr. Worry, leaping into the air.
出了什么事儿？担心先生尖叫着，一下子窜到空中。
Or at least, he tried to leap into the air, but found that he was already there.
或者说，他正想要窜到空中，却发现自己已经在半空中了。
The alarm had rung because there was a meteor shower heading their way.
警报响起来是因为有一场流星雨正在向他们袭来。
Don't worry, cried Mr. Strong, who leaped into action.
别担心，强壮先生喊着。马上采取了行动。
He bounced around the surface, catching the meteors and throwing them back into space.
他在火星上东奔西跑，接住了那些流星，把它们扔回了太空。
After a few days on Mars, it was time to go home.
在火星上待了几天，是时候回家了。
Captain Strongarm started the rocket, and they began to rise into the air.
斯特朗阿姆舰长启动了火箭，大家乘着火箭开始升空。
Goodness gracious! Exclaimed little Miss Wise. We've left Mr. Small behind.
我的天哪！聪慧小姐尖叫起来，我们把小小先生落下了。
I can't stop the rocket now.Cried Captain Strongarm.
斯特朗阿姆舰长喊道，我现在没有办法让火箭停下来啊。
Who Poor Mr. Small, he was so small, nobody had noticed that he was still on the surface.
可怜的小小先生，他太小了，谁也没有注意，他还在火星表面。
He was going to be left behind on Mars.
他要被留在火星上了。
There was nothing they could do.
大家一点办法都没有。
Also, they all thought, until Mr. Bones jumped out of the rocket's hatch, grabbed Mr. Small by the scruff of his space suit, and bounced right back up to the safety of the rocket.
大家正在无计可施之时，弹跳先生从火箭的座舱里跳了出去，一把抓住了小小先生的航天服衣领，然后纵身一跳，两个人都弹回到火箭里，安然无恙。
That's what I call a bouncy ride, cried the captain's strong arm.
斯特朗阿姆舰长喊道，我管这个叫做弹跳式搭乘。
Captain Strong Arm was very pleased with the mission.
特朗阿姆舰长对这次任务的成果非常满意。
It had been a great success, and they had collected lots of samples to take back to Earth.
这次取得了巨大的成功，他们采集了许多样本带回地球。
Mr. Wrong looked at all the samples.
错误先生看了看这些样本。
It seems a very long way to come just to collect some rocks, he said. There are lots of rocks back on Earth.
他说，跑了这么远的路，就为了捡几块石头，太不划算了。地球上不是有的是石头吗？
On the way home,They stopped at the International Space Station for tea.
回家的路上，他们在国际空间站停下来喝茶。
Where are the trains? Asked Mr. Wrong.
错误先生问，火车在哪里呢？
It's not that sort of station, sighed little Miss Wise.
聪慧小姐叹了口气说，这不是那种火车站。
Mr. Wong also couldn't understand why their tea was not in a cup and saucer.
错误先生也不能明白为什么他们的茶不在托盘上的茶杯里呢。
So little Miss Wise showed him why.
聪慧小姐向他解释了原因。
While everyone else was having tea,Little Miss Naughty sneaked out and went for a ride on a satellite.
趁大家都在喝茶的时候，淘气小姐溜了出去，坐上了卫星出去兜了兜风。
All the way around the Earth.
她绕着地球转了一大圈。
It only took 90 minutes for her to orbit the Earth, and she was back in time to catch the space shuttle home.
只用了90分钟，他就绕地球转了一圈。他回来的时候正好赶上航天飞机回家。
The space shuttle plugged back through Earth's atmosphere with the same force that everyone had experienced when they had taken off.
航天飞机在地球的大气层里急速穿行，那股强大的冲力大家在出发去火星时曾感受过。
They splashed down safely in the sea.
他们安全降落到了海里。
Well, said little Miss Wise to Mr. Wrong, I think I can safely say that that was the very best tour any tour guide has ever taken me on.
聪慧小姐对错误先生说，告诉你吧，我可以肯定地对你说，从来没有导游带我经历过这么美妙的旅行。
A very, very, very long way away. 140 million miles to be as precise as little Miss Wise.
在很远很远很远的地方，如果要像聪慧小姐那样精确地说，是 1.4亿英里之外。
Mr. Impossible settled down in his deck chair to enjoy some peace and quiet, when a small voice said, Hello!
不可能先生舒舒服服地躺在自己的沙发椅上，享受着安宁和平静。突然，一个小小的声音说，你好。
It was a Martian.
是个火星人。
That's impossible, I hear you say.
那不可能，我听见你说了。
But is it?
但是真的不可能吗？
Thanks for listening. See you next time.